Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to 6A Varsity Soccer with your Union Redskins taking on the Owosso Rams tonight live in Owosso. And you're watching on UnionSportsNetwork.com. Thanks for joining us. Our pregame show brought to you by EllisTeams.com. That's Tracy Ellis and his team at Keller Williams, proud sponsors of Union Soccer, and Case & Associates, another proud sponsor of Union Soccer. So I'm Brandon McCombs. He is Brett Dickey. And Brett, as we come out tonight, what a great night for soccer. And Union looking to reverse the tide as the girls fall tonight 6-0. And how do the boys kind of turn this around and get things moving in the right direction?
Well, you know, without watching the Rams play yet this season, you know, they're going to have a totally different style on the field than what the girls did. Both the boys' teams are going to play differently. I know they probably feel bad about the loss that the girls took tonight, and maybe they're looking out to have a little vengeance in the second game.
So the starting lineup for the Union Redskins tonight is in goal, Miguel Bustos. Number 2, Griffin Brown. Number 3, Riley Walker. Number 5, Brady Hawkins. Number 6, Jonathan Solorzano. Number 7, Leo Da Silva. Number 9, Miguel Torres. Number 10, Chris Barrera. Number 12, Miguel Embris. Number 14, Jason Duran. And number 17, Kyle Easley. And so Union ended up losing Tuesday night to the Heritage War Eagles from Rogers in a 2-2 tie that went into PKs. They lost 5-4. And tough way to get your season started, but playing very impressive to start and then kind of fell apart toward the end. And we'll see how they rebound tonight, Brett.
Well, there's only one way up from a first game loss, and that, you know, come out and play strong. Wow.
And boom, just like that, Union gives up a goal. And 19 seconds into the game, Owosso strikes quick.
Again, not a good way to start a game. Got a bunch of players trying to toss blame around right now. It may have been on more than one person.
Yeah, the back line there. Susceptible and struggling right here on the onset. We'll see how Union rebounds from that. It's Brady Hawkins back to Riley Walker. There's Griffin Brown in the middle, and that's Kyle Easley, number 17.
So if you went not a typo, Owosso comes out 19 seconds into the game and pops one in. Union hoping for a rebound off that.
Popcorn, that does sound good.
Mm.
That was a nice little adjective to throw out there. I like popcorn. Oh, tonight, the Union men defeat Jinx. And nice save there by Miguel Bustos. The women win last night. They're into the state tournament. The men knock off Jinx tonight. And what many would consider to be an upset. And so Union, both men and women, moving into the state tournament in 6A basketball. And we've been calling their games all year. It has been an exciting group of young men and young ladies to watch. So continue to follow them, and we'll continue to keep you updated here on UnionSportsNetwork.com. Throw in. Another great chance there just a few seconds ago there by the Owosso Rams. And Leo Da Silva on a nice tackle.
One of my favorite captain resetting.
One of my favorite players on the Union team, number 7, Leo Da Silva. With a name like that, you've got to be great at soccer, man. I said that last broadcast, but it is so true. And he is a great young man.
Right, tripped up by his own feet and still maintains the ball. Finally loses it.
There's Miguel Torres, and he gets a little... He got sandwiched right there. Great job there by Brown.
Steps in and overlaps. He's still open there on the wing.
Right now, this game looking very fast break oriented.
They can only last for so long playing with that intensity. Things will start to slow down as they go. But right now, Owosso probably riding a little bit of a high after that first goal and coming back a few minutes later with another great attack. The Redskins have to find a way to overcome that high they're riding right now. Upfield, good first touch. Played up top. Ball sent across the center. It's still alive. Too many touches.
That was number 14, Jason Duran, and could not get that under control. You know, the other night we saw an unprecedented amount of long balls from the back line. We'll see tonight how, if that continues or if we continue to see more of that tiki-tac Mike Wilson style of soccer.
Do you think Wilson wants to see those long balls?
You know, nothing that we've heard or ever seen. I think an occasional one is always good, but we've never seen an onslaught of them like we saw the other night. And I think there was a little bit of frustration of losing that midfield battle and continuing to pass up all the other teams. So instead of making a narrow pass, it was, if you're going to make one, make it 30 yards downfield.
Right.
And that's all speculation because I hadn't talked to the back line, so I'm not sure what that was.
Well, we have a set piece here for free kick given to Owosso. And this, again, is a dangerous area. You don't know if the ball is going to be played short to the front or all the way to the back post. It appears that Owosso is lining up on the back post, but you never know where that run's going to be made.
So, Brett, what we can see here is he's going to swing this from left to right into the middle, and you're going to see Owosso moving toward it, just trying to get to that back post. There you go.
Well handled by the goalkeeper.
And in a chaos situation like that, that's a tough ball to handle. So kudos to Miguel Bustos.
Throw in Redskins. Immediately dispossessed. Brady steps up into the center. And regained by the Redskins. Up the... Oh. The referee says play on. That is a surprise.
That was Miguel Torres and Chris Barrero. We call him Chico. Making a dynamic run right there. And it really looked like the player got all of the ankle. But
it looked like it from up here. I'm up here in the box. So. But it sure looked like a foul in the center of the field to me. Ball finally finds its way to the ground, kept in play by the Redskins, and then put out of play by the Rams for another Union throw-in.
You know, one thing I think we can expect to see tonight, Brett, is Union trying to play through Chris Barrera and Miguel Torres. They are an offensive juggernaut of a firepower. And so, you know, the rest of the team trying to play through them to create opportunity is something that we'll continue to watch for.
So far, it's just been getting the ball to them that's the trick. And I do believe that they can figure that out in due time. Ball one in a dangerous area. Unlucky attempt on the cross.
That was number 14, Jason Duran, and just didn't go the way he wanted it.
We tried to strike that on goal. Played too tight by the Ram defense, cleared. Redskins seem to be playing with a lot more intensity now.
Well, they found a rhythm, you know, Brett, here in the last about 3 minutes. They really were able to settle down and find that triangulation that Coach Wilson really preaches and teaches in practice. And that triangulation, moving the midfielders in and out to create a chance to move the ball side to side instead of hitting those big cross field passes all in one swoop. You know, well, combinations are important.
These players all know that if they stay in their form and they can position themselves on the field correctly, that they'll always have an open teammate to find pass to feet.
Yeah, so very much so.
Rough when the goalkeeper takes the ball. And referee is making quite a few of the Union fans upset early in the game.
One of the best refs in the state, in my opinion. Had him many, many times, and he definitely, I think what we'll notice as the night goes on, he'll be very consistent.
Yeah.
And so far, but he's been very consistent both ways with the squads.
I agree. If he lets it play for one, he's got to let the same play on the other side, and so far it looks like he's doing that. And I do like to see the refs let him play. I like to, you know, despite what some people think, soccer's a contact sport.
So this is going to be a corner. You're going to see a huge push right here from Owosso.
Played near post and doesn't stay on the field. Brandon, if a corner kick goes into the side netting, does it help your team?
No. You know, I call that a ram shot. And it's amazing that we're here in the land of the Rams.
Yeah, that's correct. Great ball pushed in. Just two steps behind it all evening so far.
You know, Brett, we saw with the girls' game, just continue to see where Owosso Rams, and so far it really has continued.
Makes himself open for a shot. And frantically cleared by the Rams, wiping the sweat off their brow on that one. Referee saw the heel clip there and calls one for the Redskins.
Again, when you look at the ref, he's done a fantastic job. But again, just a minute ago, one side not liking the way it goes, but he continued to call it back the other way. And I think we're going to see a very consistent game from the guys in blue tonight.
Yeah. We did in the girls as well. It's the same crew, and they're doing a fantastic job out there tonight. Good decision out there on the right side to play that back and restart this offense. Find your form, which they have. Ball being played to feet fairly well. And Union is really doing a good job of winning their 50-50 balls out there. The score doesn't show that, but great steal. The center mid dropping in to cover for the right back until he gets back in position. Easily defended by the Redskins again. And the Rams with a reset.
You know, tonight as we continue to watch this and how it unfolds, the experience against the inexperience is really the tell of the tape tonight. The Union Redskins, inexperience, only four returning starters from last year, and Owosso, 23 seniors. Yeah. And so it'll be an experience to see how that continues to unfold moving forward.
Well, and it's good for them. It forces them to develop faster. It forces them to develop not only as skillful players, but also forces them to develop the relationships with the other players to get better communication. People overlook that a lot, that, you know, as you play year after year with the same people, you begin to know what they're going to do with the ball before they do it, and that just comes from experience playing with the same people for.
There are only four juniors on this Owosso team. Everybody else is a senior. The goalie is a junior, and then three field players. So we'll keep an eye on that. That'll be number 14, and number 32, and number 37.
Redskins on attack. That is a great ball played. Center back steps in, and the referee does see this one as a foul.
And that's Chris Barrera who goes down. Chico right at the edge of the box. And that's a spot that he's going to want that free kick from.
Well, the Union fans love it, but the Owosso fans hate it. Again, though, referee calling it very consistent.
So Chris Barrera, you know, Brett, for all of our listeners, he is an experienced player. Many would say one of the best players in the state of Oklahoma on any team anywhere. On this is Kyle Easley, and number nine is Miguel Torres.
We're about 20 out. Are we going to see this one going to be a shot on frame?
Yeah, I think you'll see this from Miguel.
And there it is. And sails.
Oh, that
just
was
a bit high.
That was Kyle Easley trying to hit that back post.
It was a great attempt. Didn't have the dip on it that he wanted.
He hit it. Just a missile line drive. We'll see how that kind of sparks Union's juices right here.
There's two players that know what they're thinking right there. They don't even have to ask for the ball. They know it's coming, and that's the communication that you get when you've been around somebody playing for a while. Brendan, do you know, do these players, do they play on the same club teams together?
They don't, but, you know, Miguel Torres plays at Oklahoma Energy, and Chico plays over at TSC, but they're really good friends. They're the heart, soul. They're the engine that drives this thing offensively. And, you know, Miguel playing up top, Chico playing that number 10, that attacking mid. Like I said about 10 minutes ago, we're going to watch and see how they combo all night long.
Well, they are really in tune with each other. You can tell on the few attacks that Union have had that involve those two. They know what each other's thinking before they think it.
Well, and, you know, again, it's just trying to figure out. That's Jason Duran on this side, and he's got some wheels.
Unlucky on that ball. He meant to play through, but it's still retained. And a rifle shot against the glass of the Owosso Wellness Center.
So,
did you know Owosso had a wellness center there?
Well, I see that written
up. I see it
up,
now.
Big, giant, six-foot letters up on the building. I notice after I think all the high schools now have at the one end zone, they have a building. And I believe that was started by yours truly, the Union Redskins.
And the ones that don't should.
Well, they just haven't caught on yet. Kyle Easley out there, he's got a good left foot. And
had it on that left foot, maybe thought he had a little more space than he did.
You know, Brett, right now I continue to see Union is getting some opportunities. They're just not able to really push through that last wall of defense yet.
Well, the goal in the first 19 seconds of the game maybe caught the Redskins a little bit off guard. But
since then, it has been a very even game.
Well, I would even say that it's since then has been maybe even dominated by the Redskins. Have had quite a few attacks. And, I mean, the attacks that Union is putting together are well-thought-out offensive plays. These aren't, you know, long over-the-top balls or hard through balls that just, you know, forwards are running after.
So that's a substitution, Brett. Kobe Wicklin checks in, and Miguel Torres moves out to the wing as Kyle Easley takes a seat.
So the substitution there by Wilson, is that an offensive strategy, do you think, or is he just replacing some tired legs?
Well, it really creates a lot of speed out on the flank. That's going to be a foul. And Chris Burrow's getting a lot of calls right now, and that's going to be a card. And we'll see how that continues again to unfold, kind of like fouls in basketball, repeated calls one right after another, and a great rule in soccer if you're the opposing team, that individual right away. But with that last substitution, Coach Wilson gets a lot of speed. You got Jason Durant out on one side now, a little speed. Miguel Torres moves from up top. And Kobe Wicklund, big, strong young man, created a goal the other night. He's great at playing with his back to the goal and just creating some havoc.
Well, I'd like to note that the fouls in the middle of the field on the Union forwards and attacking center mids, that these are a lot of times fouls out of frustration when you know that you're maybe outmatched and the only way that you have an out to keep that ball from going in the back of the net is maybe a strategic foul.
I think that's exactly right. So you're going to see a lot tonight. Continue to watch in the white on Union. Number 10, Chris Barrera. We call him Chico. Very elusive, very quick. Again, one of the top players in the state of Oklahoma. So he's going to create a lot of problems. And, you know, he's already been fouled really hard twice now. I mean,
well, and if it keeps up, you know, we may see more than just the one yellow card because eventually you run out of fouls that you can be given. Ball cheaply given away there. Doesn't look like it's going to amount to anything at the end. Here again, the Owosso boys' attack this evening has been hard through balls and over the top balls that don't find their way to feet a lot of times, and you know, may have been just a little bit of a luck there in the 19th second of the game, and caught the Redskins a little bit off guard there. Since has been very well dominated by the Union Redskins.
So just checked in, Jason Duran checks out, and Jonathan Perez, he's a freshman for Union, has checked into the game.
Wasso with another shot from distance that can't find the frame. Trying to find his way around, decides to pass the ball off, played back across through the center, still played to feet. And Owosso happy just to kill that one.
Kobe Wicklund, he's got a pretty good arm on him. This should be coming straight into the middle of the box.
So this is one of those corner kick throw-ins. There it is. And it is a rifle into the center. And Union still with the numbers up, but able to get deflection and win the throw-in. Bad first touch there. And another one. Gives it right back to the Redskins.
Continue to see Chris Barrera double teamed, triple teamed every time he's touching the ball. They're very aware of where he's at.
Yeah, I think the coaches have probably done their homework on that one. So as a strategy, if you're Wilson, do you try to get him to take as many defenders with him and open up the field to somebody else to step up to the plate tonight?
Well, you know, I think one of the greatest tools that Chris has is that it's off the ball movement. He's great at finding the open space. He's great at triangulation, like right there. I mean, he
comes in. Referee says that's a clean tackle. Looked good to me.
TEllisRealEstate.com. Again, thank you to Case & Associates, a proud sponsor of Union Soccer, and to everyone who brings you UnionSportsNetwork.com, from our cameraman to our producer, Andy Irwin, and to the wonderful athletic system through Union, and a fantastic athletic director, Miss Emily Barkley, who continues to support us and everything that we do. They're going to be making a goalie switch here at 15:29 as hopefully it's just a cramp, but it looked like he came down on that wrong.
Yeah, I couldn't tell. Producer up here says he thinks it's a knee, but they're stretching it like it's a cramp, so I can't tell what it is, and
that'll be
maybe a cramp right above the knee at the bottom of that quadricep.
Not enough potassium.
Well, you see that a lot of times when you get these chilly evenings, and maybe they don't stretch out as good as they could before.
How do you get
the game
rid of cramps? Isn't it?
Well, the best way that
bananas?
I found is, they say naturally you can eat a bunch of bananas.
Come on, I love nanners.
Stay hydrated before the game, and then stay hydrated during the game, and usually fight off those cramps.
It's hard to do it during the game. Brad, he's playing.
He's a goalkeeper.
Oh, he can drink while he plays.
Yeah, they can.
All right, they get him off. I'm a big fan of nanners. I tell you what, as many of those as you can eat.
I'm glad somebody out there likes them. I'd rather just drink water.
All right. Well, what if you put the banana in the water?
That's definitely not something I would put on. He's up and walking, but he still looks like he's in a little pain.
So the goalkeeper that just came in, he is a senior. So they have not lost anything as they go from one to an upperclassman. And
immediately,
there's Chico again.
Redskins on attack again, and there's a push to the back that is going to be called, but it is just outside of the box. Chico wants it in the box, but looking up here, I'm pretty sure he was outside of the box.
Yeah, again, just the momentum carrying him inside the box. That was a great call again by the referee. Miguel Torres is going to put it right on the line.
Is that a statement?
I think that's a, so you've got Chico and Torres Miguel there. You got Kobe Wickley. Now, again, Kobe's big, strong, tall. He's going to try to create somewhere. That guy can't get to the back post. They're going to try to bend this.
Yeah, he's going to try to hit that back post, and the obstruction on the keeper is going to help that. Here it comes. Delivery low to the back post.
Great. And that was and right
higher,
there. Again, you can't talk enough about fundamentals, watching the ball, not trying to do more than what you should. And a great defense there by the Rams.
Cleared by the Rams and still maintained. Referee calls it back for a Union free kick. Again, not sure what that one was, but I'm going to trust the referee. Shot on goal.
And
point
goal.
Blank, and it's a goal. And the persistence pays off, and it looks like it. Nope. Thought it might have been getting called back. Nope, that's a goal.
That was number 9, Miguel Torres. And, again, just a rocket.
Oh, we got a yellow card.
And Chico gets a yellow. He picked the ball up, and then he brought it. He punted it out, and just completely unnecessary. But I tell you why they sort that out, and he subs for a minute. A great job of Union with 13:31, Brett, to find their way to play in their lane. And, again, it was Chico creating. He drew three guys over, and Miguel was wide open, and they're combinating, again, off of one another.
Well, I hate to see that. I understand the excitement, especially of going back 1-1 for the equalizer. But I hate to see getting a yellow card on something like that. You know, you'd like to be able to burn that one later on in the game. Now he doesn't have that tool at his belt, and he'd be risking a red card later on. So maybe a little better self-control next time. I'm sure Wilson's going to counsel him on that.
Yeah, it was 2 years ago that Ruben Carrasco ends up scoring the game winner late in the game and waves his jersey as he takes it off right in front of the home crowd and the bench and gets a straight red. So Union knows how to pick up cards here in Owosso.
Got a collection.
So
be the second corner kick issued to Owosso.
After that first 19 seconds, Union has played very, very well. They've gained control. Again, the offensive firepower of Chris Pereira and Miguel Torres. But they have not been able to really generate anything in the midfield to create any problems for the back line of Union.
Yeah. Let's see if this set piece is run a little better. And it is a much better corner kick right to the head of a Ram that can't find that back post. That's a close one.
Yeah, I don't think he was expecting that one.
Union gets away with one there. Again, ball played out of the back. Union happy to build their offense out of the back. And that shows a lot of confidence in the control. Making a great run down line. Tried to slow it down with the head flick. And
again, though, another long ball.
Well, and some of them make sense, Brandon. I mean, if you look downfield and you see a run being made and your player is already at full speed, the defender's flat-footed, you can make that play. You got to be able to drop it in on the backside, though, where your outside mid can catch up to it before it goes out of bounds. Tried the last time to slow it down with the head flick, and it just wasn't quite enough. Union resetting, slowing down the pace a little bit. Now you notice that Union can change that speed of play on a dime. They pull it into the backfield, slow down the pace, and then all of a sudden they're going 100 miles per hour again. I like that about this team. Owosso fans below us getting riled up. Referee says play on. And they will.
I tell you, they're getting excited about everything.
Yep. Home number crowd 20, trying
number
to
number 23
get the team
is a freshman. That is David R. Lenino.
So consistently, this ref is watching the heel clips tonight and has found four or five of them to go Union's way tonight. Again, that's part of the consistency that crew is showing tonight. And he's letting some stuff go, but he doesn't like those heel clips.
Yeah, and so what we can expect to see right here is Miguel Torres, he's going to fire one. I'm expecting to see this on the goalie's right.
Tries to punch it through the wall and almost does. Kept alive by Brady. Still alive. Again, Owosso fine to get rid of it.
Kobe Wicklund's going to launch this one again into the middle.
It's going to be like a corner kick. Watch for the head. Played to the center. Off-balance shot.
Oh, that goes through the uprights. That should be worth 3 points. A great job. I mean, he hit two of the uprights. It ricocheted across, and shame. There's
too bad that doesn't go on the scoreboard.
No bonus points for that. Another freshman checks in for Union as Miguel Embris checks out. Eric Villalobos checks in at left back.
Owosso trying to put together an attack.
keeps possession and then slows down the pace. They're going to have to reset.
That was a nice job there.
Wausau just a little bit sloppy on that final third, and it's keeping them from getting the payoff. Held on to it a little too long.
So right now on this left side, you got two freshmen, Jonathan Perez and
our jaw jacking going on there. The ref didn't like it, said that's enough.
Well, and he flipped the ball after the play. They stopped the clock at 7:02. And now. And Kel Hunt's going to check in as Kobe Wickland takes a seat.
Excellent footwork in the middle of the field to keep that possession.
Number 11's also checked in. Tyler Reynolds is a sophomore. There's Kel Hunt. That's Tyler Reynolds right there. That doesn't have enough juice on it.
Played directly up the middle, easy to defend. Just appear the last couple of minutes that Union might be feeling a little too good about this. They've gotten a little bit sloppy with the touch. Need to get reeled back in and play the way they started.
Number 18's checked in also. That's J.C. Guerrero. He's a sophomore.
Great ball played again to the center. Reset. Ooh.
Not the pass
unlucky
you want.
Ball.
But
luckily, the Rams were unable to make them pay.
Kobe Wicklund's moved all the way to right back. He played there last year. And Owosso had a man streaking and just could not hit him.
Played all the way down the side.
Great ball that just ended up being in the right place. So, Brett, we go inside 4 minutes here on UnionSportsNetwork.com. He's Brett Dickey. I'm Brandon McCombs, and we thank you for joining us on this beautiful Friday night as the Union Redskins taking on the Owosso Rams live here at Owosso Stadium. Owosso scores the first night 1-1 tie with 3:30 to play. You know, Brett, one of the things that you see as this game's unfolded, Coach Wilson has gone to the bench. He's got multiple players in, you know, continuing to see lots of underclassmen moving in, and the future of Union soccer is super, super bright. It's bright this year, and, you know, Coach Wilson always getting the most out of the kids that he has.
Well, that's good to get some of them experience at this level this year when at all possible. It just sets them up better for next year. Some coaches, you know, decide to live for the moment and try to keep the best 11 out there as long as possible. But anytime you feel like your bench is deep enough to get results by going to the bench, it's good to get them out on the field and get them some experience.
Well, unless I am totally miscounted, I believe we have our 20th kid already in the game tonight.
And that's great. That's good. Ball put into the mix, didn't quite make it.
Excuse me, 18 we've had him.
Looks like a promising run. They're getting the numbers forward. Can they maintain possession? It's going to be a shot with a little bit less mustard than what he wanted on it. You like mustard too,
don't
you?
I like mustard. Is that spicy mustard, whole grain mustard? I was afraid you were going to tell me Grey Poupon.
Grey Poupon? Another shot, and that one.
Union dodges a huge bullet that hit the crossbar.
Would you say that?
And dodge another one just off the mark.
Would you say that he loves the pole right now? That the pole is his
best
friend?
I would say that that pole is that goalie's best friend. He loves the pole. Inside of a minute, Miguel Bustos is probably praising the pole.
Yes.
I mean, you might say, Miguel.
Is that like the Festivus pole?
I mean, he might be airing his grievances at
he
halftime.
Could be. I think he could be.
Definitely have seen the feats of strength unfold here in the
that's correct
for all of our Seinfeld friends out there.
Gets a little comfortable back there and realizes he needs to hurry up and get rid of that. Great ball played over the top,
just a little bit strong.
That
was a little much, but what a great way to end the first half here.
Man, if that ball had a little bit more angle on it, I believe that one would have been in the back of the net.
All right, that'll do this at the end of the first half. It is all tied up here at Owosso. The Owosso Rams won, and your Union Redskins won. We'll be back with the second half in about 10 minutes. Grab your popcorn, grab your soda. Don't go anywhere, fans. We've got us a game here in Owosso on UnionSportsNetwork.com. Welcome back to the second half. I'm Brandon McCombs. He's Brett Dickey. And we are live in Owosso as your Union Redskins are all tied up at the half with the Owosso Rams 1-1 in 6A varsity soccer. And, Brett, outside the first 19 seconds when Owosso struck very quickly, Union has had a great performance here, led by the Wonder Twins of Miguel Toros and Chico Barrera.
Yeah, I expect to see more of the same out of Union coming into the second half. The starters are going to go back in, I expect. And if they can not get caught off guard in the first 19 seconds, then I see quite a few more goals. I mean, we're talking two or three just in the second half if they come out and strike first.
Our halftime show brought to you by Ellis Teams and Associates. Over at Keller Williams, look for Tracy Ellis and his team for all your home, residential, commercial, farm and ranch, and luxury homes. Give the Ellis team a chance over at Keller Williams. Also, thanks to Case & Associates, all proud sponsors of Union Soccer. All right, Brett, here comes the second half. Take it away.
Right. Ball's going to Owosso. Start off the second half. Let's see if they've cleaned up their touch a little bit. Let's see how well they possess. They start off big, going over the top. And that is very dangerous. Luckily cleared away. Also coming out quick, just like they did in the first half.
Well, I think it's a congratulations to the Redskins. They escaped the first 19 seconds that time.
So the first attack by the Redskins there was not what Wilson wants to see. He wants to see a little more organization. They'll get it pulled back together, I'm sure.
You know, one of the things I expect to see here in the second half is a lot of the guys that are on the field right now for Union spent the last 10, 15 minutes on the bench. So they've had a half hour plus break here, and so they should have a lot of juice in the tank. And here comes Chico as he just beat them all.
And he unselfishly delivers that to his teammate that buries it. And that's exactly what I was talking about earlier today. These two play together like they play together their whole life.
Yeah, they're right there again. The Wonder Twins, that is Chris Barrera again, hitting the ball straight across over to Miguel Torres, who just jams it in the back of the net. And again, fundamental soccer, Mike Wilson style.
Well, and what I really like to see is the unselfish play of Barrera shoving that ball over to his buddy. He could have had a shot on goal and a good shot had it on the left. Great, great offensive attack there.
I mean, he only beat about five guys here in the second to take the lead. And since that 19 seconds, it's 2-0.
Well, and just before that attack from Union, I was actually going to comment on how the Rams seemed to be a little more calm. They seemed to be looking to put that may just pull the threads out a little bit farther. We may see a little more frustration come out like we did the first half. Ball played to the center again. Given right back to the Redskins and then reset. Hawkins plays out of the back. Unlucky touch on the outside mid.
So here's that. Let's go back and look at this. There's one, two, three, four, five guys he beats. And right there, he sticks it across. And, you know, when you can take someone of his magnitude to be able to beat five guys going down like that, that just really opens up the rest of the field. And Miguel Torres, again, what you do without the ball, more important sometimes than what you do with the ball.
Absolutely.
And 100% staying up with the play, waiting for his buddy to hit him with it.
Well, and it also helped on that play. The goalkeeper comes out and kind of comes out softly on that one. You either have to come out hard or don't come out at all. If he would have stayed in, maybe Torres doesn't have the easy shot. If he would have come out hard, maybe Barrera gets dispossessed earlier. So that's something they'll find out on tape. If that may have been a little goalkeeper error as well, but still a great play they put together, and those two just continue to.
Well, and remember, we're on the second string goalkeeper,
and that could be part of it. Ball bounces over the top and completely run over. The referee sees it and is going to give him a little counseling on that. Hopefully he'll keep his mouth shut and will not get a card.
Nice little high five after the action. Now, you got to love the tenacity that Kobe Wicklund shows there. You know, not the speediest guy on the field, but, you know, Kobe Wicklund, a very, very smart player, and knows when to turn on the juice, when to play hard. And right there, maybe just delivering one of those, hey, buddy, I'm going to be here all night. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, I guarantee you. Call that a love tap. Wicklund on the left. And the Redskins are going to reset off that. A throw in. Immediately dispossessed. Nice attempt there on the flick. Barrera knew it was coming.
That was a little street ball soccer right there, 101. If that gets through, Barrera's gone again.
Going to be a corner kick for the Rams. Looked like a goal was sold a little better by the.
I have a left footer on this. He's going to try to bend this in, and they're going to take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys and crash the box.
And communication there. Barrera going to pressure. Giving the right back a hard time.
Yeah, it's number 14, Jason Duran right there. He definitely has a lot of speed.
Looks like goal kick is going to be played deep. Overlap and run by the Rams. Kept in. Trying to cut in. Teammates want a pass. He gets one off. It's going to be a free kick awarded to Owosso.
That's passed all the way across the field. They've stopped the clock. The ball sits right in front of the Union bench and no one touches it.
Ball put in the mixer, headed off frame. Well, the Rams have proven they can be a little bit threatening on the set pieces between the corner kicks and the free kicks. It
it's not time to rest against the Rams set pieces. Rams. 8 minutes in. Score Union 2, Owosso 1. Ball won at midfield and lost at midfield.
And there's a goal right there. And the back line, just a little disheveled right there. And misplay there. And they stick that through. And a great finish there by the Rams to tie this up at 31-25.
Well, Brandon, it's just a lazy pass there. Didn't find its target. And it continues to be an issue that we're seeing. All you have to do is lose concentration for 1 second, and that's all it takes. And the Rams make the Redskins pay for that one. Let's go get it back.
So, again, to see this young team and see how the adversity, how they kind of react here. They responded great in the first half. We'll see how they do here in the second.
Rams want time to reset, so that one's played out.
Union was up 2-0 on Tuesday over Heritage and ended up losing that one in a penalty shootout. And tonight they've tied it up at 1 and then go ahead 2-1, and now it's tied 2-2. And I think tight games are something we're going to see all year, Brett.
You think they're not happy unless they're tied?
There's Miguel Torres. He is quick and he is feisty. He is fun to watch.
It's going to be a goal kick for Owosso. I think may have held on to that ball a little bit too long. Looking back, maybe a cut back to the center on the deck would have been a wise decision. But sometimes you're out there, you're dribbling with your head down, and you just got your eye on the prize. Ball played long.
And the goalie's down. And Miguel Bustos, the senior goalkeeper, takes a little tumble there. Cameron McCollum, the backup goalie, he's a freshman and very, very good. But looks like Miguel's going to be okay. Good news for the Redskins.
Well, I think the Rams thought that he came in a little bit too hot on that one. I disagree. I think that was clean play all the way around. The striker going in strong and the keeper going in strong.
You know, but a testament to Union, whether it's a goalie or whether it's a field player, they have depth all the way around.
Wise decision by the Rams goalkeeper to come out and clear that one. That was almost trouble. Cut back, but not far enough. Headed out by inside out pass tried to be completed and was intercepted. And the Owosso Rams fans are going mad. They do not like the calls that have been made the last few minutes, and they're showing their opinion.
So number 10 for Owosso, that's Colby Bauer. He's a senior, and he's just playing.
Good sportsmanship there. Helps him up. Sends him on his way.
I believe Chico and Colby are friends from club days gone by. So a little bit of love there in a fun way.
In the I still want to beat you way.
Probably.
Free kick directly to the middle. Direction changed. Slot ball doesn't find its intended receiver.
So we're just inside 27 minutes now. We're at 26:40 to play, and you're watching on UnionSportsNetwork.com. It's all tied up 2-2 here at Owosso.
And the flag stays down.
Bauer let that one get away from him. He's still trying to calm down from the foul over here a few minutes ago. So Union definitely getting in Colby Bauer's head right now.
Boy, if he was on sides on that run, he was only there by an inch. The ARs tonight have been doing a great job of calling it, so I'm going to put my trust in him. Union slow out of the back. And long ball played down the line again. Not sure if that's part of the strategy or if he saw something that was there.
Jonathan Perez checking in. Have not seen Kyle Easley here in the second half. And I don't know if he got hurt in the first. But he was not out much of the first half after starting the game. Hard foul there on Owosso.
Brandon, I'm not sure if he's calling a foul. I think he may have just been stop and play. He's going to go confer with his AR.
Yeah,
the AR may have seen something.
Yeah, I'm afraid the AR saw exactly what happened, and you might see a card come out here. It was well after the play. And so they're going to – yeah, this is what you're going to see.
No, he's stopping the play. It's going to be a free kick awarded to the Owosso Rams.
Oh, but he's not going to card anybody. He's just going to give him a free kick.
You know, the fans are getting a little bit upset about that, but you can't expect the center to see something that happens behind a play. That's why he has the ARs there, and the ARs did their job again.
Seen lots of players trying to flick balls. I'm not a big flick guy. Very rarely does that work. But we've seen lots of.
Oh, and that's a great ball play to the center. And Rams get lucky. The center back makes it back. Just gets a toe on that.
And that was not a flick. That was a good header. Good job from Owosso to shift the field.
Yeah. That's another one of those heel clicks that he has consistently called.
He's called every one of them tonight.
You know, something he doesn't like.
You're sitting 100 feet above the playing surface. You see every heel click, don't you?
Well, if I can see it, then I'm sure he can see it, and I know what he's calling.
I mean, sometimes they kind of fall like somebody's dancing or something, a little heel kick toe all the way around.
Again, Union slow out of the back. That shows that they are confident that they think they're going to put another one in the back of the net. They're not in any big hurry with 23 minutes left to play, second half.
Much better job tonight from the Redskins playing their patented Mike Wilson soccer. Just, again, the triangulation, the moving the ball up and down. Still a few long balls that we're not used to seeing in the past, but a very, very good job of looking to move the ball.
We're going to see a shot here.
And that's right through the upright, and it's a shame that Owosso's not getting points for field goals tonight.
And that one is sitting in Craig County right there.
David Arlenio checks in. Perez moves out from the center to the out wide. Kobe Wicklin takes a seat, and Kel Hunt moves in back into the game.
Also with numbers forward, I was expecting to see another shot.
That was a great job by number 7, Leo Da Silva, just interrupting, getting in the middle of the passing. You know, one of the things that you don't see a lot from the young people playing today is everything is goal, 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 score, run forward. But to be able to get in the middle of a passing lane, be able, again, it's what you're doing when you don't have the ball. Oh, and a great job by Owosso as they score right there. And it's, again, right in the center of the field. Union continues to have a little bit of a struggle right there. But a great cross, a great play through, and a breakdown right there. So Owosso at the 19 mark, they jump back on top 3-2, and it has been a goal fest tonight, Brett. Yeah. 5 goals, both teams playing out of their mind. Very disciplined, well soccer, but again, just a mental breakdown ever so often. And in a game like this, a split second could cost you a goal.
Well, the ball was played very well by the Rams on that last goal. But again, it's a breakdown there in the center, right in front of the goal. You can't allow that to happen. You can't let the opponent touch the ball anywhere near that 6. Not only were they able to get a shot off, but they had 2 passes to get to the player before the shot was taken. So that just shows you too much space was given there. Not enough respect to the attacking force of the Owosso Rams.
So warming up over on the sideline right now is number 16. He's a sophomore, Cannon Marth, and he'll be coming into the center back position for one of those guys. And then Eric Villalobos, they are 2 of the star standout players on the JV2 team. And they've given up 1 goal all season long. And that was not a defensive thing. It was more of a goalkeeping. So, great job there. We'll see what Coach Wilson dials up here in the last 20 minutes of the game. You know, Owosso definitely got a little bit shimmy back in their step after scoring those last 2 goals.
Oh, just miscommunication. And then he may have been better off to carry that one. He had space.
Yeah, Miguel Torres, he's going to get a free kick. 30 yards out.
Friendly handshake there. What do you think, Mr. McCombs? Far post on this one.
I think he's going to put it right on frame. Now, when he hits the upright, you might say field goal kicking may not be in his future. So with 18:40 and the clock continues to tick and to run, not Union's ally at this point. Again, Brady Hawkins checks out and Cannon Marth checks in. A great job there. And again, you just see this energy that is kind of, you can feel it 200 feet up here. They are really got a little skip in their step right now, does Owosso.
Well, 18 minutes of soccer is plenty enough to get another couple of goals. Have to see what Wilson's got up his sleeve. Make sure he's got the right people on the field to get this job done. Again, slow out of the back, so that does show their confidence.
Yeah, Cannon Marth, a fantastic young man. He'll do a great job back there. Owosso making a sub here.
Cannon Marth, is he new to the varsity squad this year?
Yeah, he's a sophomore, and again, he anchors that. He's team captain of the JV2, anchors that back line with JV2, which is a very strong team here at Union. Lots of future stars. Cannon does a fantastic job of just kind of, like I said, anchoring that down and putting his team in a great position. Cannon comes from a great soccer family, from
big
his older brother.
Soccer family.
Big soccer family. His brother Colson, who's a freshman, plays on that squad with him and plays right back some. So, you know, as a parent, you get to watch both kids. I know what that's about.
Well, for those of you who don't know the Marth family, their whole family is dedicated to soccer and especially youth soccer. And I know for a fact both the Marth boys have spent all winter help train young kids in the Tulsa Metro to up their game.
So right there again, a nice little play there, and Union was able to dodge that one.
Ball played quickly down the line. Little jersey tug there that referee says it's okay.
So it's about he's going to call that.
Nope, he's going to call it.
Yeah, you give him a foul right there. So Cannon's going to take the kick. Eric Villalobos back to David Arlenio. Back over to Griffin Brown. Very quiet, but a great game by Griffin tonight. Chico was making the run, and Wasser Ram saved a goal right there, probably. 15 minutes to play. You're watching on UnionSportsNetwork.com. He's Brett. I'm Brandon. And we thank you for joining us here tonight on a beautiful night for Union soccer.
Ball played over the top.
Nothing to worry about with Griffin Brown there. Chico's been pretty quiet here in the last about 15, 20 minutes. We'll see how that changes to as the game continues to move on.
Well, I have noticed that the Rams have figured out a way to clog some of those passing lanes that the Redskins were using in the first half. They've done a pretty good job of clogging it, not letting that ball through the second half so far. Well defended by Union. Put back in the mix. Not going to be an issue. Big punt. Given back to the Rams. They slowly work the ball out of the back.
Great job by Griffin again. Ah, Aaron passed back to the wrong guys.
Again, another miss hit that.
Well, if you're just joining us tonight, we want to give you an update. Last night, the Union girls won to move on to state. And tonight, in basketball, for 6A basketball. And then tonight, the boys also win here in Owosso, beating the Jinx Trojans, and they move on to state. So both the men and the women's basketball programs moving on to the state. And here at Sports UnionSportsNetwork.com, it's been a joy watching them progress and grow all season long. And so congratulations to them, and good luck moving on for that 6A title in men's and women's basketball.
So as the clock ticks away, second half of this game tonight, Wilson needs to see some urgency out of his players, and they need to take advantage of every opportunity that they have at this point.
So Kyle Easley, Miguel Toros, and Brady Hawkins all checking back into the game here in just a minute. So here they come. We'll see where they check in at.
Oh, do we have Brady Hawkins
going
up top, huh?
Yeah, he brought Brady off, gave him a little chat, Brady's played a great job of doing forward last year, so we'll see what kind of havoc he can wreak up top. Great job by Jonathan Sorozano. He gets Chico the ball.
Keeps it in play but can't maintain possession.
Going to call a handball almost 40 yards out.
Let's see what Union can do with this.
So Brady back up top with Kobe Wicklund checked in back on the back line now for Griffin Brown, who came out. Griffin getting a little attention over there from the trainers and chatting.
Ball a hair too deep.
Oh, and the goalie is down, and that was pretty vicious. This could cause a slight problem for if he doesn't jump right back up, because they're already on to their second goalie. With this break here at 10:10 here on UnionSportsNetwork.com, he's Brad Dickey. I'm Brandon McCombs, and we are live here at the Owosso Rams home on a beautiful Friday night that's a little chilly. But a great night for soccer nonetheless. And we've seen Union get down quick, fight their way back with two unanswered goals, to turn around to give up two unanswered goals. And it has been a game of ebb and flow. high, low, but they've never stopped. And here with 10 minutes to play, I would suspect we're going to see it just all to the wall.
Well, and I've watched Wilson coach last year, and I know that he can get those boys playing different styles of soccer. Obviously, he's mixed things up here at the end by moving his center back up to play forward, and there's got to be a reason that he sees to doing that. So is he going to push more players up to help put the ball in the back of the net, and is he going to trust the guys in the back line to be able to keep the ball out of the net while they're trying to score?
Well, you know, right now, again, with him playing as many as he's played, with 10-10 to play, down by one, again, Kyle Easley played about the first 10, 15 minutes, and then he hasn't been back on, so he is totally fresh. Brady Hawkins got a breather. You know, you begin to see Miguel Torres was out for a little bit. He got a breather. And Owosso has subbed a little, but they have not used near the depth that you've seen Union use tonight. And so in this last 10-10, we'll see how conditioning and how a sub rotation really comes into effect.
It's like Brady thought he had a corner kick there, and as well as I. Looks like they're going to give the ball to the Rams keeper for a goal kick. He's up on his feet. Everybody's happy. He feels good enough to go on.
Kobe Bowers had a really good game, number 10 there for Owosso. So he's
worked hard all night.
Very hard all night.
In fact, I don't think, has he come out of the game?
I do not think so. He's definitely been the little engine that could all night long.
And he's still going like he did from the beginning. Good decision by Hawkins there to play that back. Now we have numbers. Carried a little bit too far there. Under 10 minutes now to play in the second half.
Yeah, so we're at 9:04 to play. We're going to correct that on your screen right now. Another Owosso Ram down.
It's another Owosso player that's been on the field the majority of the night, been working hard. I think he might be happy to come off. Free kick, set piece awarded to Union Redskins.
You know, a lot of these guys play club ball together, and outside of this, you know, tomorrow they could be playing at a tournament with the guy on the other side and laughing and joking about the game tonight. And that right there is why you got Brady Hawkins moving forward like that. Not just because it's a set piece, you would have pushed him forward anyway, but he creates havoc over there just with that, you know, style of play of just throwing himself into things. And so you got to love the heart and the effort that he does that with.
Well, every single one of these set pieces in the closing minutes of this game for Union are going to be important. It's what they do with the opportunity that's going to make a difference. So they run, obviously, a play, and it almost gets away from the Rams keeper. That ball had some pep on it.
Yeah, Kyle Easley unleashed one, and the goalie, he's...
I think he's having to catch his breath right now.
He grabbed his heart. That's for sure. I might have a little tattooing of
great save by the keeper.
I don't know what kind of ball they're using, but I bet it tattooed him.
You'd be able to see that Adidas sign on there.
I think they're using a select ball, to be honest with you, but nice job there by them to continue to. Leo Da Silva with a great, and he's going to get the
call
foul.
That back. That was definitely a hard challenge.
Again, Kobe Bauer doesn't like to play number 10. Starting to hear a little chant now. Let's go, Union. Let's go, Union. You see assistant head coach Matt Funk running down in front of the student section for Owosso, trying to get them going now. This last 6 minutes, ladies and gentlemen, do not go anywhere. This is going to get fun. The electricity is in the air. And as you're watching here on UnionSportsNetwork.com, what a fantastic game we have had tonight between the Rams and the Redskins.
Well defended by the Rams, and they have been locked down on that side the second half.
Union, the one that has to push here in the final 6 minutes, down by one. Owosso probably content to just clear the ball, sit back, and great job by Kobe Bauer.
And the Rams just want it on that half of the field. They don't care where it goes as long as it's
Oh, and a pass right back to him. Now, there was a little clip right there that was not caught as he jumps back up. And Riley Walker,
he's going to have to come out of the game, it looks like.
The clock continues to run. He either needs to get up or stay down. They're losing precious seconds here. And they're going to call the time right there. About 25 seconds went off, and Riley Walker injured himself right there on a – looked like a nice little clip there on the back of the heel. I think it was inadvertent.
Well, yeah. Ref can't see them all.
He's got just about every one of them.
Yeah.
Though. And so Griffin Brown checks back in. Kobe Wicklund moves to the middle. And Griffin Brown's going to move back out wide.
Oh, you got to come back to that?
Yeah, Jason Duran did not move fast enough on that one, which is a bit of
not normal.
That's an oxymoron to say he didn't move fast enough, because he is quick. Union trails 3-2, 4:28 to play.
And the AR says that's going to go the Rams' way.
So with 4:09, a very unprecedented call by the man in the middle on a sub, he calls timeout. Again, Union, when they're at their best, playing the ball through Chris Barrera and Miguel Toro, so we'll see how that moves forward here in the final 4 minutes. Kobe Wicklund has had a fantastic game. He's played different positions.
Brady with the header right to the feet.
And Miguel Torres could not turn fast enough as he had it right there at the feet of the goalie.
Hawkins again, trying to create again.
No call there. It was all ball. And they're going to clear that all the way back down the field.
Union needs to move the ball. 3 minutes left. Now probably just searching for a tie in regular time. And the Rams making it difficult. Dribbling to the corner.
Oh, that's going to be a foul.
Probably an unnecessary foul.
He's going to let the time click off. That's going to kill another. That foul right there is going to cost him probably close to about 40 seconds by the time they play this in.
You have strategic fouls, and that was not a strategic foul.
That was not. And take it, Kobe Bowers was taking it to the corner to kill time.
Yep.
But he is going to sit and kill a ton of time right here.
Upfield, letting the rest of his team work. We are inside of 2 minutes left. The Rams scrambling to keep possession and waste time. And try to get another goal out of it.
And they just got a little antsy. So there's 1:40 on the clock. And they're going to put Kel Hunt in to see if he can create anything. They're going to push forward with everything they've got now.
Easily defended by the Rams. Deep throw in. Going to look for the Redskins to push everybody they've got up. And they're leaving one back to mark the Rams striker, and that is it. Everybody in with under a minute left. Great throw in. Attempted clear, can't get it done. Forward.
Cannon Marth's going to push that forward.
And he gets dragged down from behind. That's going to be a set piece.
And it better be a quick, and they're going to stop time right there. 36 seconds. He's going to stop the time. And something a veteran referee does this.
Yeah.
And one that has complete control of the game. So a great officiating crew tonight again. 36 seconds to play. Owosso up 3-2. You're watching on UnionSportsNetwork.com. A shout-out to our producer, Mr. Andy Irwin. Thank you for doing everything he does. And think about Andy tomorrow. He'll be running in the Polar Bear Trot 5K Fun Run bright and early as he's freezing up here tonight, just getting ready for it.
Ball hammered.
And that's going to do it. That's going to kill the last 20 seconds right there. And it has been a fantastic night of soccer here. Union's going to end up falling short of a miracle in the last 10 seconds. But the ladies fall 6-0, and the men are going to end up losing out.
Teams that are victorious tonight, and they are happy about it.
Oh, I tell you what, to beat the Union Redskins in soccer is like winning the Super Bowl of the NFL. So
that's what it looks like on the field.
That's
right
exactly
now.
What it looks like. So congratulations to the Owosso Rams. Join us next time on our next telecast here on UnionSportsNetwork.com. For Brett Dickey, I'm Brandon McCombs, and thanks for watching.
Sayonara.
Good night.